Okay, so yesterday we talked about bivalves. Today we're going to talk about gastropods. Which animals are in the group gastropod?
Snails.
Snails and
good
slugs.
Job,
you guys do pay attention sometimes.
No, he doesn't.
Gastro means stomach. Pod means foot. So these are basically the stomach-foot ones. They move by a strong muscular foot. We've already kind of talked about that. Even though it's stomach-foot, the stomach is actually up inside the shell, which we saw in that picture before. Some of them are going to have eye spots on the tentacles. We also watched that one really creepy video around Halloween time where the worms infected it and got up into the eye stalks and made it look like grubs. We're talking about the parasites. But they do typically have tentacles that help them to see a little bit. Now again, this isn't like they have excellent vision. Typically, they can just see like light versus dark. They know if they're in the shade or they know if they're in the sun. Mostly going to rely on their sense of smell, and they have no hearing, so they can't hear anything. They could probably feel vibrations, but mostly going to rely on their sense of smell. The radula is present for feeding. They do not have filters like bivalves did, so they're going to use that tongue to scrape off things in order to eat.
I've never seen a slug without a shell.
With a shell.
With a shell.
Or maybe a half inch.
I don't think they're terribly common, but one thing you will quickly learn in science is you never say never. There's always an exception to the rule.
Never.
What?
All right, so that's all we're talking about with gastropods. pods today. Short set of notes today. You do have a new assignment though.
Yay!
It's getting us ready for the cephalopods, because again, the cephalopods are my favorite. They're the really cool ones that are intelligent and they can change color, and they can change shape. So it's called the cephalopod research. It's not like a paper or anything. It's some questions that you'll need to look up on the internet to answer. Now tomorrow we will probably be doing the Planera lab. As I said, I've never done the Planera lab before, so we will be learning together. I have the general idea that we've got some good instructions, and so we'll be figuring it out tomorrow. I will try to remember to bring my good microscope. I had somebody donate to, like, me personally, it was my cousin, a microscope, and it is amazing. It's the best microscope I have played with since I did my master's program. So I'll try and remember to bring my good microscope, and we can use that to look at the Planera, too. So we'll plan on doing that tomorrow as long as they come in, and we'll see how that project goes. And we'll check in on them again on Monday when we come back, because they probably will have regenerated a bit over the weekend. Okay?
Okay,
cephalopod research today. Tomorrow, Planera lab, as long as the Planeras come in.